All right, so let's begin learning the concept of do-while loop in C programming. Okay, so we'll first understand the syntax of do-while loop. Okay, how does a do-while loop work? The syntax is like this. It says do, which has its own block, and then while loop, which will have its own condition, okay, and a semicolon, and we will have statements, or we can have statement or statements inside my do. Now, when the execution comes to the do while loop, okay, the do does not have any expression or conditions to evaluate here. See, there's no expression or condition to evaluate. Okay, I repeat, there's no condition or expression to evaluate here. So automatically the code goes inside. It executes the first line, second line, third line. That means there is no check for true and false here. That means the code will go inside the do when it is executed. Now while checks for truth or false. So now when it comes here, it will check for the condition if it is true or false. If it is true, it goes back to the do and executes these lines again. Okay. And if it is false, and when it gets false, if it gets false, it exits out of the loop. That means what happens in do while loop? It will go and execute at least once. So it will execute once. Okay. Whereas in while loop, first checks for condition and then executes accordingly. So if you want a piece of code to execute at least once, you will use do while loop. Okay. Any questions here? All right. So what we'll do here is that we'll write a program. Okay. Write a program to accept a number from the user. Okay. Print whether it is or just we'll accept the number from the user, and we'll keep asking the user a number unless he presses 0 to exit. Okay, so let's say write a program to accept number from user and display it and press 0 to exit. Now if you look at the code, I can write the same code in while loop here, but then I'll show you what is the challenge writing it in while loop, and then why we are converting it into a do while loop. Okay, so first we'll write it in while loop. Okay, let's see. So hash include stdio header, then my main. Okay, and we'll accept a number from the user, so int n. Okay, and we'll say printf, enter a number, whatever number the user gives, we'll store it in. Okay, we'll store it in which variable? N. Okay, and then we'll check while n is not equal to 0. Okay, print f the value of n. So number is whatever the number is given. Okay, so we'll just percent d will display it, comma num. It's n. Okay, so we'll display it, and then again ask the user to give a number, because we need to ask him to give a number again and again unless he presses 0. So we want to accept the number and again print it. So again we'll say print, we'll just copy this line, enter a number, we'll again scan it. And this will keep on happening unless the user does not give 0. If he presses 0, then it will exit. Okay. If he presses 0, it will exit. So let's see the execution of this pro code. So we'll say GCC space. First, let me just clear the screen. GCC space do while dot C. So a dot exe. Enter a number. So it enters a number which is 5. So the number is 5, and again it is asking for a number. See, So while printing up, I just need to enter backslash n here so that it goes to the new line. So CLS, again, if you see, I will compile my code and run it. So enter number 5. So what happens? It happens 2 times. Enter a number. Okay. So we keep on entering the number. So again, it's like 10. Enter a number. So this is 60. Enter a number. So 8. Unless you press 0. Once you press 0, it exits. So these two lines which are there, okay, these two lines are getting repeated twice. See, enter a number. This is happening twice. So what I'll do is, instead of writing a while loop, I'll convert this code into a do while loop. Let's see how. So I'll say I want this to happen once, right? So this is my condition. I'll place my condition at the very end. Okay. And here I want it to happen with do. So this is my do block. I'll say while. So do what? So what we want is ask a user to enter a number. So these lines should happen first. Enter a number, whatever number he gives, we will store it in the variable n, and then print the number. Okay, and if it is not equal to 0, we will again go and ask for a number. Okay, so enter a number, backslash, and we just for it to go to a new line, and then backslash. Okay, all right. So let's see how it works. Okay. So CLS. See, we optimized our code. Okay. We optimized our code right now. Enter a number. I say 10. The number is 10. Again, enter a number. So I'll say 5. Again, enter a number 6, 89. Unless we press 0, it will not exit. So 0 to exit. When I press 0, the number is 0 and it exited from the do while loop. Okay, so see, the repetition of my code, the two lines extra that we had written earlier, has been removed. So usually when you want a piece of code to execute at least once, this code will execute at least once. Okay, let's see. Okay, for example, what I'm trying to say is that when we run this, enter a number and it says 0. See, the number is 0 and it exits out of the loop, but it will happen at least once. But if we would have written the while loop, it would have not even executed once, because the condition would have become false and the code would have exit. I hope you guys got the point. All right, so thanks for watching. Okay, and the video will be uploaded on YouTube. Okay, and subscribe to our channel, and we will move to the next topic, which will be switch case. Thank you so much.